In the villages of Mysore, life is tough if you're a rural woman, especially if you're Dalit. Back-breaking labor in the fields of the land the whole day, and then caring for the house and one's children. No stable livelihood or regular income for you or the man of the house. In such a context, access to the state's social security schemes, public health care, food rations, subsidies for agriculture and other employment schemes becomes crucial. They can be accessed only by visiting government offices at the sub-district level, about a day's journey away. This is difficult, especially for women, as they lose not only a day's labor, but also risk slander for being brazen enough to move about in public unaccompanied by men. And there are brokers and powerful middlemen who demand bribes and prevent women's access to public offices. If you are a poor Dalit woman, tirelessly negotiating with local government is part of everyday struggle. Village self-government bodies in India, panchayats, play a key role in local development. They also hold the key to women's claims. But they are invariably controlled by vested interests, feudal landlords, powerful caste leaders, and politicians. This was the situation in the villages when IT for Change stepped in. IT for Change has utilized digital technologies to strengthen the capacity of rural women's collectives in Mysore district to successfully claim their rights and entitlements. It has sought to use the disruptive potential of information and communication technologies, forging creative pathways for Dalit women's journey to equal citizenship. The project has set up a network of 4 information centers managed by local women's collectives and operated by young women intermediaries known as Sakhi, the term for friend in the local language Kannada.
ಇನ್ನೇನು ಇವಾಗ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮಾತೆ ಬರ್ತಾದಲ್ಲ ಆಗಿದ್ದೆ ಒಂದು 9 ತಿಂಗಳು ಆಗಿರ್ಬೇಕು
ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ತಾಳೆ ಹಾಕಿರೋರಿಗೆ ಸಹಾಯ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಒಂದೆ ನಿಮ್ದು ವಯಸ್ಸು ಇಲ್ಲಾಂದ್ರೆ ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಮನೆಗೆ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿದ್ದೆ
The power of digital technologies is pivotal to the center's work for mobile-based networking with government officials, for tracking applications through an MIS, for building bottom-up evidence to make claims, for running a mobile library with tablets, and for sending bulk voice messages as part of information outreach. The information centers also help community members with entitlement processing. They make information access transparent and equitable and herald a threshold change in the local power equation.
ನಮಗೆ ಒಳ್ಳೆಯದಾಗಿದೆ ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಜೆರಾಕ್ಸ್ ಇರೋ ಕಾರಣದಿಂದ ನಾವು ಹುಣಸೂರಿಗೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಜೆರಾಕ್ಸ್ ಹಾಕಿಸ್ಬೇಕಾಗಿತ್ತು ನಮಗೆ ಜೆರಾಕ್ಸು ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಸಿಗ್ತಾ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಭಾರಿ ಅನುಕೂಲ ಆಗೈತೆ ನಮ್ಮ ವಸವಾರಂಚಿ ಮಹಿಳಾ ಸಂಘ ಭಾರಿ ಇಂಪ್ರೂವ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಇಂಪ್ರೂವ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಕೆ ಖುಷಿ ಆಯ್ತದೆ ಈ ಮಹಿಳಾ ಸಂಘ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಈ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸವಲತ್ತು ನಮ್ಮೂರಿಗೆ ಬಂದಿರೋದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ತುಂಬ ಖುಷಿ ಪಡ್ತೀವಿ
The Sakhi is the key link between women and public information. She visits public institutions on a monthly basis, calling them up for information updates and checking governmental websites for public information. She then provides informational updates on a regular basis to the local community. Her journey into public life is also a remarkable story.
ಅನುಕೂಲ ಹೇಳಿದಷ್ಟಕ್ಕೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿನೇ ಆಗದೆ ನಾವು ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದ್ರಗಿಂತ ಮೇಲಾಯ್ತದೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಯಾವ ತೊಂದರೆ ಆಗದ ರೀತಿಲಿ ಆಯ್ತದೆ ಈಗ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಈಗ ಯಾವುದೇ ಮಾಹಿತಿ ಆದರೂ ನಮ್ಗೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಮನ ಮುಂದಕ್ಕೆ ಬಂದಂಗೆ ಆಯ್ತದಲ್ಲ ಈಗ
There was a time when women had to chase their entitlement, find their way into the local network of favors. Now, they get what is rightfully theirs, and better still, authorities reach them routinely to ask for favors. As owners of the centers, women have fought and won many battles, small and big, conducting household surveys for presenting evidence to authorities, bringing in new resources for the village, auditing government schemes and more. The centers are becoming a new public information infrastructure in the communities and enabling women to become a force to be reckoned with. Part of the project, regular dialogues between women's collectives and elected women have been organized. What are the common demands of the women in the community? How can women think beyond getting individual benefits and identify shared priorities? Video resources are used to inform and trigger discussions on these areas. Another key strategy is a weekly community radio program that serves as a dialogue forum of women, by women, and for women.
ಅಂತ ಸೀಕ್ರೆಟ್ ಏನು ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಡಿಗೆ ಮನ್ಲಿ ಬಚ್ಚಲ್ ಮನ್ಲಿ ಉಪಯೋಗಿಸಿದ ನೀರ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಇತ್ಲಿಗೆ ಮನೆ ಮುಂದಕ್ಕೆ
ಟುಡೇ ವಿ ಸಿ ಅ ನ್ಯೂ ಲರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಕಲ್ಚರ್ ವೇರ್ ಡಿಜಿಟಲ್ ಟೂಲ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇ ಅನ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ರೋಲ್ ಇನ್ ಫರ್ದರಿಂಗ್ ವಿಮೆನ್ಸ್ ಸಿಟಿಸನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಇನ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಟಿ ಮೀಡಿಯಾ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಟಜೀಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬೀನ್ ಯುಟಿಲೈಸ್ಡ್ to create a local discourse that emphasizes togetherness and bonding between and among women's collectives. In one of the project villages, women's collectives regularly organize a monthly potluck on the full moon night to reaffirm the spirit of collective solidarity. A film about this empowering ritual was made and shared with women from other villages who then felt inspired to organize similar events celebrating the solidarity of their collectives. The project recognizes that the control of media platforms is crucial for political power. Hence, it has carved out community radio and community video platforms where women can hone their political voice. By sharing their perspectives on the panchayat and local governance processes over radio, women feel validated as knowledge leaders. Women are being trained in filming videos so that they can tell their own stories at the community level as citizen activists leading change. For instance, the community health worker in one of the villages, who is also a member of the local women's collective, recently shot a film on the Nutrition Day celebrations in her village. The Nutrition Day is an awareness generation program organized by government-run child care centers with community contribution. In addition to using community media, the project has utilized GIS technology to get women's agendas on the local governance map. In one of the project villages, women had expressed their dissatisfaction with the local government body's allotment of subsidies under a universal sanitation program for the construction of household toilets, its poor attention to the upkeep of streetlights, and the supply of drinking water to houses. Therefore, a GIS-facilitated participatory mapping was carried out to track local government expenditure on these areas. The results were shared with the local government body and community members to generate a discussion around accountability. Bringing out the truth, making tacit knowledge open, is a high-risk proposition. It goes to the heart of local vested interests, opening up questions like, where is the money that came in the name of the people? There is a long road ahead, and the endeavor to creatively utilize the disruptive potential of ICTs to further women's active citizenship has just begun.